Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and we're going to take a look in this video at installing Ubuntu 15.04, the first systemd release for Ubuntu. So the first thing to be able to install Ubuntu, of course, we've got to get the media. So we can go and fire up our browser. And if we point our browser through to ubuntu.com and move through to download, and then we can choose to download the cloud, which is the OpenStack environment. We can choose the server, so without the graphics. We can go through and choose the desktop. By default, we're going to be presented with the long-term support version, and that's then currently the trusty tar here, 14.04. If you want to get to look at systemd on Ubuntu, then download 15.04. Once you have downloaded, it will come down as an ISO file. If you're using virtualization software such as Oracle's VirtualBox or VMware's VMware Player or VMware Workstation, then of course you can install from the ISO directly. Otherwise, burn it through to a DVD. Once you're ready with that, we can then start looking at the installation. If we wanted to run the live edition, so if we're installing on a real hardware and we wanted to check that it was going to work before we carry ahead with the install, we'd use try Ubuntu. We're going to use the install Ubuntu. It's obviously a virtual machine, so we know we can carry ahead and not worry about destroying anything. So we've run our check, so we have got the available disk space, we are connected to the internet. I'm not going to be worried about installing updates whilst we're installing, because if we did this, it would take a lot longer to install, and obviously we can worry about updating the system afterwards. I'm not going to worry about additional third-party software. We're now looking at partitioning the disk, so we're going to erase the complete disk and install Ubuntu. It will use its own method for creating the partitions, and it's going to give me a single partition for the root file system and a swap partition. But we could choose different setups, or we could customize our own setup with something else. Again, for the moment, we're going to keep it simple. But in your own environment, a lot depends how much disk space that you have, what the system is going to be used for, and of course, how many disks you have within the system. So we get a summary of what's going to happen, that we're creating a new partition table. And then we're having a partition for root that's going to be formatted with the ext4, the extended 4 file system, and a partition that we're going to use for virtual memory. So we can then choose continue. Being connected to the internet, being able to check my location, has given me a time zone of London. It's making a best guess at my keyboard and giving me a UK keyboard, which is good. And now we're setting up our super user. So I'm just going to put in a computer name, and we can call this then Vixen. And then we can just have Tux and set up the password. I don't particularly need a full name, but you could choose to put one in if you want. And then we can continue. Now we can allow the process to go through, and we can expect it to take a few minutes for it to install, but depending on your system, allow it 15 minutes or so. Having given it a little while, we can see now we're ready to restart, and the system will go through its reboot, and then we're ready to log on. Now, to get the full resolution of your desktop, you might have to install VMware Tools or your VirtualBox extensions if you're using a virtualized system. But of course, if you're using a physical system, if it detects your graphics driver, then you should be presented with the full size desktop. But there we have it. We've installed 15.04. And as I say, this is the first release from Ubuntu that uses systemd. The big thing about this is it brings a certain amount of unification to the Linux desktops, so we're not so much worried about the different commands that we have to manage our services. They're going to be the same across Debian, Ubuntu, Red Hat, and SUSE. Thank you very much for watching. I look forward to seeing you back on the Urban Penguin channel very soon.